friends, welcome to this video on mathematics. In the previous class, we learned about linear equations in one variable. Here are some examples. Such equations have only one variable and its maximum power is 1. Therefore, it is called the linear equation in one variable. Today, we will move one step further and discuss linear equations in two variables and their general form. Let's try to understand this with an example. Neera and Shaurya together planted 40 saplings. Can we write this in the form of an equation? Yes. Let's see how. We don't know how many plants Neera and Shaurya planted individually, but together they planted 40 saplings. Suppose Neera planted X saplings and Shaurya planted Y saplings. Together, they planted 40 saplings. So, we get x plus y is equal to 40. This becomes an equation. Let's look at another example. Bablu scored 2 times more than Raju in mathematics. Suppose, Bablu scored m marks in maths and Raju scored n marks. Note that we can use any other alphabet instead of m and n. Given that Bablu scored 2 times more than Raju in maths, we can represent it like this. We can write it as m minus 2n is equal to 0 as well. And we get another equation. Can you tell how these two equations are different from a linear equation in one variable? Come on, let's see. In these two equations, the variables are x, y and m, n. The maximum power of both is 1. Hence, both of them are linear equations in two variables. We can write the equation x plus y is equal to 40 and x plus y minus 40 is equal to 0 as well. And from this, we reach this general form. Generally, we write it in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Here, x and y are the variables. A is the coefficient of x, b is the coefficient of y, and c is the constant. Friends, an important point here is that a, b and c are real numbers. And both a and b cannot simultaneously be zero. Can you tell me why is this so? If both a and b become zero, both x and y term becomes zero. And we will be left with only a constant. Is the equation x is equal to 4 a linear equation in two variables? We can write it as x minus 4 is equal to 0 or x plus 0y minus 4 is equal to 0 as well. Now, it is in the form of a linear equation in two variables. Here, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 0 and c is equal to minus 4. So, we can say that even if either A or B is 0, the equation can be represented in the form of a linear equation in two variables. In the next video, we will discuss this in detail and learn to make a linear equation in two variables. So friends, today we learned about linear equations in two variables and how to write it in general form. See you in the next video. Thank you.